What if you're wandering around an Audi showroom and you decide that what you really want from your new car is a cross between a TT coupe and a Q7 SUV? You want the sporty, sleek lines of the coupe, but you also want the raised up ride height and practicality of an SUV. Well, the good news is that you're now in luck, thanks to this, the Q8.
From its launch in the summer of 2018, it will become the German brand's flagship SUV, taking the fight to rivals such as the Mercedes-Benz GLE Coupe, Porsche Cayenne and Range Rover Sport.
Thing is, this is the first time that Audi has made a coupe SUV cross, so it's a bit of a step into the unknown, as is filming a car review in the middle of a very, very windy Atacama Desert. But then there's a first time for everything, isn't there? Now, despite this car being heavily based on the Q7, the interior is actually completely different, and that's because it follows the design of the A6, the A7 and the A8. Therefore, you've got these three large screens which dominate the cabin. There's the virtual cockpit screen, which we've seen on other Audis. There's this upper display here, which controls things like sat-nav and media and your phone. We've also got a lower screen, which does things like change the climate control settings and the park assist. All in all, it's basically like sitting in a higher up A8, and that's certainly no bad thing. Now, before we take this car out for a drive, do be sure to like this video and subscribe to the Parker's channel for more brand new car reviews just like this one.
We're going to do this driving section a little bit differently to how we'd usually do it. So normally I'd talk to you and there'd be some B-roll and voiceover overlaid on top of that, but this time we're going to do the whole thing as voiceover and B-roll, so you get to see this car in what is frankly spectacular scenery, and it should hopefully make a change from just seeing my face. So enjoy. Based on the same platform as its Q7 sister car, there are understandable similarities in the way the Q8 drives. It's very smooth and refined, with the air suspension delivering impressive ride comfort over all but the worst road surfaces. Both the 3-litre diesel and petrol engines are barely audible when cruising, although there is a squeak of wind noise from the wing mirrors, a trait shared with the A8 saloon. Where the Q8 deviates from the Q7 is in the bends, where the former's lower ride height and sharper steering gives the car a more agile feel. It's not enough to turn it into a hot hatch, but it is an improvement dynamically over the Q7, without seemingly compromising too much on comfort.
Now, hop in the back, and despite the Q8's sloping roofline, there is an impressive amount of headroom in here. I'm sitting up and, well, I've got plenty of room there, and I'm perfectly comfortable. It's the legroom though where this car really impresses in the back. There's loads of space here. I can really stretch out. It's just like sitting in an A8 almost. Unsurprisingly, the Q8 has significantly less boot space than the Q7 in 5-seat mode, although it is still competitive with the Range Rover Sport, BMW X6 and Mercedes-Benz GLE Coupe. The space itself, well, it's a good square shape, and there's not much of a lip between the loading lip here and the actual boot floor. Needless to say, that electronic tailgate comes as standard on every model. Audi has been late to the party with its first SUV coupe, but from these initial impressions, it shouldn't have too much trouble playing catch up. It feels more special than a BMW X6 and a Mercedes-Benz GLE Coupe, and the cabin is a lot nicer than that in a Range Rover Sport. If you want the finest, most opulent Audi SUV, this is it.